demands which were put forward by Pakistan Expire Association. That is, number one, withdrawal of the withholding sales tax, withholding of sales tax. That was a long awaited demand from us, and we acknowledge that they have accepted this demand. Then we have also requested on various occasions to them to create a devastating difference between the filers, Burhan or Khan, if we are ready, if you do it from 10% to 20%, so that non-filers should feel the pinch and the filer should feel the benefit of being a filer. So the difference is created, but still I'm not satisfied with the business. It should have been there. Rather, filers should be reduced, the reduction rate should have been more reduced as compared to the non-filers. Then the third point, which I would like to say they have accepted from our recommendations, is the non-appointment of their BPS 20 officer as judicial member of the tribunal. Well, that's very welcoming. We also wanted independence of judiciary, and that is a step towards that. We welcome that. Then withdrawal of section 122C, to some extent, it suits the taxpayer, and it will ease the pressure on the non-delayed filers. These are the few points which I think we put forward and that we have accepted upon, and yet we are thankful that we are for that. Now the second part. The second part is Tax Reform Commission, Tax Reform Implementation Committee, Tax Simplification Committee have put their sweat into different recommendations. 278 pages, if I am not wrong, 278 pages of Tax Reform Commission still lies on the bookshelf of FPI. That is the sad point. That discourages the tax fraternity. The blood, the time, the devotion they have put into it has been still waiting for implementation. All this, what has been said by President Aziz Taibani, is with this, they're written in this Tax Reforms Commission. I would strongly request the FPR through Mr. Ramkul Abazin, that please, these books are not the Modi Haman Commission or the other commissions which comes after 50 years, and we believe that it has to be worked upon. We have the committee members, the commission members have really put their efforts, their professional integrity, and their whole knowledge, their experience behind all of these committees and their recommendations. They should be given some weightage into it. Coming on to some of the recommendations which were there, put in by different tax parts, commissions, and Pakistan tax file as well. Was pointed out that there was 214D, removal of 214D, decrease of penalties in order to increase the tax base. Because in this present, I have not seen a single measure. I would like to know from the learned member that what are the measures they have adopted to broaden the tax base. Rather, it is more of twisting the existing tax base again. Discouragement of the corporate structure. Cost of doing business of corporate structure has gone to 42 to 43% with this dividend rate going to 15%. The take home would be something around 54-55%. This is highest among all of this Asia area, or maybe most part of the world. So we have to see, at the same time we are asking for a corporate culture, and at the same time they are discouraging them. I am surprised to see the withdrawal of Clause 65A, which was an incentive given to the person who is making 90% and above sales to the sales tax registered person. And they were given only mere 3% tax credit in their tax liability, 3%. They were not. I still recommend that it should be made 95% of the sales tax made to the registered person should be entitled to 3%. Let's do positive, let's go forward, let's not take our steps back. NPOs are being taxed, which has been done. I don't want to take much of your time because I've seen Kala Raman working this morning at 8 a.m. in his office preparing the presentation of his budget. So I don't want to be a hurdle between you and him. I would like to give this chance to the learned speaker of today, Kala Raman, and Hassan Malik, and Adnan Mufti as well. Please, and thank you very much to Expire Tax Buyer Association for inviting me here and giving me a chance to speak to my lovely audience as always. And thank you very much. God bless you all, and happy Holi to month of Ramadan to all of you.